Mother Nature has kept government officials with FEMA busy this year.
There's been an overwhelming number of weather disasters in the country this year, causing the repairs in our area to be delayed. 4029's Joe Ellison joins us live in the Floor County tonight. And Joe, many counties are still waiting for federal funding.
Well, you know, from Northwest Arkansas to here in the River Valley, many roads and bridges were damaged from the April funding. Now, many counties, they did declare a disaster emergency waiting on the funding, but they're still waiting on that money to come in, and they don't know exactly yet when that's going to be.
It's nice. It just makes life a whole lot easier.
Greg Wolford can use this brand new bridge to leave his home on Black Fork Drive in southern LaFleur County now. But since heavy floods hit our area in April and washed the bridge out, he's been driving about 10 miles out of his way every day.
My Jeep, it gets 16 miles to the gallon, so that's an extra gallon. So that's an extra 5 gallons a week.
LaFleur County alone had around $700,000 worth of damage to bridges and roads.
This bridge right here was a $77,000 bridge. It had to come out of our general budget.
Sequoia County had millions. This bridge on Highway 101 north of Nicut was washed out. Plans are being drawn up for a permanent fix, but it's still closed. Most counties like LaFleur, Sequoia, Benton, and Washington have received word they'll get federal funding from emergency disaster declarations, but say the process with FEMA is a little backed up.
And several major disasters like Joplin, and it's just tied up so many of the FEMA teams that they've not been able to get to us to complete our process.
Which may mean some counties like LaFleur won't be able to afford a fix on their own. They'll have to wait until the help from the government shows up in their bank account.
This will be the last bridge I'll build until I can get, you know, until I can get reimbursed.
Now, many counties like Washington and Benton, they will receive public and individual assistance on a federal level, but they don't know when they'll receive those funds. Now, that's unlike Sebastian County, who says they do not meet the FEMA threshold standards, and they won't receive any funds. Back to you.
Okay, Joe, thank you. There's no word yet on when money is expected to be given to the county.